Topcoder Open finals took place around a week ago, and I want to discuss with you problem 4 distinct digits from that competition. We were given two integers x and l, and our task was to find any multiple of x that has length exactly l, this is the number of digits in this multiple, and there are at most 4 distinct digits in this number. X is up to 10 to the 11, and the length l is between 40 and 120. Let's see an example. If x is this value and l is 6, then we want to find a number that is x, or 2 times x, 3 times x, and so on, that will have exactly 6 digits in its decimal representation, and there will be at most 4 of them that are distinct. And one valid solution, but not necessarily the only one, is this number, 376363. It is, I think, x times 13, but, well, it doesn't matter. It should be a multiple, that is, x must be a divisor of this number that we found. The length is exactly 6, and the digits that occur are 3, 6, and 7, so there are 3 of them, and it satisfies the condition, at most 4. But how to do it for much bigger x? I strongly recommend that you pause the video right now and try to solve the problem on your own. What would maybe work for smaller x is to take some set of digits, maybe just 0, 1, 2, and 3, set of at most 4 digits, and try to create some numbers, or just all numbers of some length with those digits. And maybe for smaller length and smaller x that would work, but here the answer might be very long, and we will, just by assigning digits randomly, we will likely not get a multiple of x. Can we do something smarter? There are some similar problems that are solvable by DP, or graph theory, where we imagine a long number, and let's say that we choose digits from right to left. We already chose some digits, and we are right now here. We want to know what is the remainder of that part that we fixed. And I will say that this is maybe DP, or maybe just RI is possible of this remainder R, modulo x, and we want that to be 0. If we add a new digit here, like a 2, then we know what will be a new remainder, and this way, for every remainder r modulo x, we can find some number that gives exactly this remainder, if there is any, and in particular for r equal to 0, we will find that number, so a number that is divisible by x. But we cannot possibly have this dp, because if r is up to x, it is between 0 and x minus 1, then there are x possible values and x is much bigger than what would fit in time and memory. We need some other solution. Before I tell you the whole solution, first a hint in case you haven't solved the problem yet. The solution is randomized. You can again try to solve the problem on your own. What can we generate randomly? We can generate a number of length l with digits 0, 1, 2, 3, and let's force the first digit not to be 0. But this will give us, let's say, a number divisible by x with probability 1 over x, because we will get some remainder modulo x, and we can estimate the probability as such. Actually, this is not true, especially if x is not coprime with our base, that is 10. Because, for example, for x equal to 10, the remainder modulo 10 just depends on the last digit, and the other digits do not matter, but for a moment let's assume that this is true. Still, this isn't probability that satisfies us. If we try some number and we succeed with this probability, we need to try again, on average, x times. That's too much. If you see a constraint like x is up to 10 to the 11 or 10 to the 12, you should often think about complexity of square root of x. And something related to square root of x and randomized algorithms is birthday paradox. If you generate around this many random numbers between 0 and x minus 1, you should get two equal numbers. Can we use that in any way? Turns out yes, and it gives us quite a simple solution. We can generate numbers of length l, for each of them compute the remainder modulo x. Let's say it will be 5, 20, then, I don't know, 7, 8, and so on. And eventually, we will get a match, a number that already appeared before, say, a 7 again. And then we know that we have two numbers that usually will be distinct, it's not very likely that we'll get two numbers that are exactly the same, because we generate like there are around 4 to L different possibilities of numbers with digits 0, 1, 2, 3 and length L. So likely those two numbers that we have are distinct. Let's say they are 2, 1, 1, 1, 3, 3 and the other one. And now the difference of them will have remainder 0. If two numbers give us remainder 7 modulo x, then their difference will give us remainder 0. So the difference is divisible. And we can just take the bigger one, subtract the smaller one, and we have number of length L or slightly smaller. It is possible that, for example, this digit was also 2 or something similar. And then the difference, if you subtract this number from this one, you will get 2, maybe 1, then some other digits. But this first digit is 0. Is that an issue? No, it isn't, because if you have this number that is divisible by x, you can just add 0 at the end, forget about this first 0, and you still have number divisible by x. For example, 77 is divisible by 11, but 770 is also divisible by 11. By multiplying times 10, we don't make number not divisible by some number. If you watch the video carefully, you should now ask a question. Wait a minute, but we assume that probabilities are uniformly distributed, that we get each remainder with the same probability 1 over x. And this is not true, as we saw with x equal to 10. This is also not true, for example, for x equal to 9, because then numbers like 10, 100, 1000, so no matter where you will put 1, on what position, the remainder modulo 9 will be 1. And that's bad, because probabilities are not the same for every remainder. But here's an important fact to remember. The birthday paradox, or attack, birthday attack, doesn't depend on uniform distribution. In that well-known problem about birthday of children in the same class, we actually don't use the fact that for each day of a year, the probability is the same. If, for example, most children are born during summer because of some factors, then still the birthday paradox holds true, and actually it makes it even more probable. If for every day of a year we have some probability that a child will be born on that day, and they don't have to be equal to each other, so it doesn't have to be 1 over 3, 6, 5, can be completely different for every day, still the birthday paradox holds true. The thing that says, if you get more than square root of the number of days in a year, children, you will usually get two children with the same birthday. The fact that some days are more likely, are more probable, only helps us, because it makes it even more likely that one child will have the same birthday as the other, because they can be born on that same day. In particular, if 90% of children are usually born for some reason on the 1st of June, we should expect that a lot of children will be born on that same day. It helps us. And it's the same thing in our four distinct digits problem. The fact that some remainders are more likely, maybe it will be, for example, remainder 1, only helps us. And this is why we can say that the complexity of our solution is O of square root of x times L for operating numbers of length L, times some small constant like 10, so that we would be sure that there are indeed two equal numbers. And just like in other randomized problems, you shouldn't really choose some constant that you get a random number 1,000,000 times. You can just take every next random number, put that into some hash map, and stop when you see that new remainder that you computed already exists in the hash map. Then you have a match, you compute the difference, append zeros at the end if you need to, and you have a solution. But hey, what about four distinct digits that we want to get in our final number? If we only use digits 0, 1, 2, and 3 to generate our numbers, from which we will take 2 and take their difference as the answer, we can get, in the difference, we can get digits, I think, 7, 8, 9, 0, 1, 2, 3. That's much more than 4. This is an example where we get a digit 7. How to fix that issue? This is not very hard, because we can just take random numbers with digits 0 and 1. Just take binary numbers with length L. We still have enough options that we will not repeat numbers, but we want the same remainder twice. and after you get some two numbers, like this one and maybe this one, you say bigger minus smaller is the difference that we want, and my claim is in the difference only those digits will appear, 0, 1, 8 and 9. In particular, 0 minus 1 will give you 9 in the resulting difference, but then you can carry minus 1 to the left, and from this you can also get 8. I'm not going to present the formal proof for that, but you can experiment a little bit and see that you will get only those digits, and yeah, there are only 4 of them. The answer, the difference of two binary numbers of the same length, but this one doesn't matter, can give you only those digits in the answer. So we satisfied the condition about 4 distinct digits. One incorrect idea I want to mention is meet in the middle, that you might want to try if you see L that is at least 40. Like, even if L is more than 40 in the input, you can get it down to 40 at the end, append with zeros. For 40, it looks quite natural and reasonable to split the number into 2. For each half that is of length 20, try each of 2 to 20 possibilities. So there are this many possibilities for a binary number. For each of them, compute the remainder, some value a. Do the same for the right half, you will get remainder b. And from those two sets, try to get such a and b that a plus b is 0 modulo x. Then you will get the remainder. Of course, by here saying that the remainder is a, we mean number that would have here zeros. Then if this number has remainder a, and then to that number we add, say, 1111 that has remainder 7, if the sum gives you 0 modulo x, then this number in total will give you 0 modulo x. Why is this incorrect? Even though 2 to 20, the number of numbers that we have is much bigger than square root of x. So here maybe two digits are enough. The thing is that probabilities are not uniform. The distribution of remainders modulo x is not uniform. We talked about some values x for which it's true. Like here maybe on the left, you will only get some number of possible remainders, in particular for x equal to 10 or some other special values. And then we cannot say that values a and b are random, and then we cannot use something similar to birthday paradox. Birthday paradox says no matter what distribution you have, you are likely to get two equal numbers, but not necessarily, for example, numbers such that a plus b will be 0, or that a times 2 is b, if you need that. Something similar is an issue if you try to add two numbers. If you, for example, generate binary strings of length l and try to add them, again, you need a plus b equal to 0 modulo x, and it's very hard to get that solution to work, but possible with some hacks and fixes. But not possible to prove, I guess. I hope you liked this Topcoder Open problem and my video explanation. See you next time. Bye!